What's up, everyone, and welcome back to Movie Rates. Julie and the Phantoms is the new musical attraction. The ghost band show on Netflix is certainly our obsession. With its amazing music, cute couples, and a great message for friendships, the show has reached an amazing success. If you are like us, you have watched the episodes more than once and you have cravings for more, so this video is all you need. Keep watching to see the deleted scenes that would have changed the show completely and prepare to find out some amazing facts about the show that comes from the same director of High School Musical. Number 7. The plot. Ghost band and a lot of romance? The perfect Netflix combination. Luke and Julie have so much chemistry that it's hard to believe they're acting. We have never wanted a ghost and a human, a live human, to be together more than now. But there's also a human boy asking for Julie's attention, and there comes the first cliffhanger of season 1. The storyline shows how ghosts become a part of Julie's life, and her passion for music is back thanks to her ghost buddies. There's so much that the show offers. Why would the ghost stay? Why is there someone who would want to harness the energy of ghosts? And what about Julie's little brother? Will he ever find out the truth about her sister's skill to talk to ghosts? And probably the most interesting one, if Julie and Luke appear as a couple, how will that work? Well, since we have these many questions, the writers of the show did a great job. Now let's go behind the scenes and find out more about this amazing cast. Number 6. Season 1 Deleted Scene. The new deleted scene from season 1 of Julie and the Phantoms was released, and if they chose to use it, well, it would have probably changed everything. The clip is from the first episode, and you can see Julie, Madison Reyes, running down the stairs and Flynn, Jada Marie, going after her. Flynn helps Julie to get back into the class and shows them that she can sing. I've tried for myself. I've tried for Miss Harrison. I've tried for you. I've tried for Dad, and I've tried for Mom. For a whole year, I've been trying, but I can't do this anymore. I can't. I'm done.
I've tried for myself. I've tried for Miss Harrison. I've tried for you. I've tried for Dad, and I've tried for Mom.
What's really interesting is that Jada Marie shared the clip on her Instagram and said that the scene brought them closer together, IRL. Number 5. The Story. For any of you not familiar with the show, Netflix's Julie and the Phantoms is an enjoyable musical series about three ghosts who are only noticeable to the talented Julie. The series is loaded with great songs and loving moments while Luke, Reggie, and Alex try to discover why they're still on Earth. Created by High School Musical director Kenny Ortega, the show sends a message about what's really important in life. There is a romance between Julie and Luke as she tells her ex-crush Nick that she likes somebody else. Julie is a teenage girl who has lost her mother and is overcome by grief, so she can't find it in herself to return to playing music. That's when the three ghosts show up in her mother's old music place. They are very young, very talented ghosts who died before they succeeded to have their big break. Collectively, the four of them create the band that brings Julie's passion for music back, and the boys have the chance to get popular again. There's this question that fans have about Julie being the only one who can see the boys, and they certainly live in her mother's old music studio, but considering that they're all somehow linked because of her mother, shouldn't all the family members be able to see them? Why is Julie the only one? According to some fans, music is the thing that connects Julie and the ghosts. Do you have another theory about this? Let us know! Also, press that like button if you haven't done it already. Number 4. Most Difficult Scene to Film. It's been a long time since Julie and the Phantoms was released, but fans can't stop talking about it. The amazing plot is one of the reasons this show would continue its story. Let's hope for more seasons. One of many being the fact that it is getting great reviews as a really good and promising Netflix original. As fans come up with different theories about Julie and the Phantoms season 2, and they continue to wait for Netflix to drop some information for the really anticipated season. And as we're craving for more, the only thing we can do is go behind the scenes with the amazing cast of the show. In a recent event, Madison Reyes talked with Cinema Blend to review Julie and the Phantoms. She mainly talked about the scenes that she found hardest to film. And let us tell you something, we can't believe how talented this young actress is. The young star revealed it was a scene from the season finale that was the most challenging for her. The most challenging scene had to be Stand Tall and the alleyway scene. It was really mentally draining and coming up to be the last week of us filming. So those feelings were 100% real, and it was our last performance together. It was really sad because we put so much effort and work into it, and it was also a good payoff. She also said that Stand Tall was a new song they'd gotten while they were in Vancouver that ended up getting cut because she couldn't sing it fully. It was too high at the time. As a band, we had a lot of input on it, and we really grew as friends and a family while creating it together, she added. And for some of you who are not familiar with this scene, the alleyway scene in the finale was really heart-touching. And according to many fans, the young star did a great job here. Let us know what you think about her performance. Number 3, the cast. Now, we've mentioned how talented Madison Reyes is. She's enthusiastic, and she has an amazing voice. She makes the ideal protagonist for the show, and it's hard to believe that she's only at the beginning of her career. But her co-stars are not the ones to be underestimated. Especially the chemistry among them, made up of Charlie Gillespie, Owen Joyner, and Jeremy Shada, is off the charts. The most amazing thing is that when they're not shooting, they look like they've been friends for a really long time. Dedicated Disney fans will certainly smile when they see Jada Marie or Boo Boo Stewart on the screen. And one villain is played by our fave, Cheyenne Jackson. Have you seen his moves? It's pretty amazing how talented he is. Now, as we said, they are all pretty close IRL. If you follow Jeremy or Charlie on Instagram, and we know you do, you can actually see how strong their bond is, and the love among them is really obvious. Just look at them having the best time of their lives. The diversity in this show is also highly appreciated, which is not the case with so many shows and movies nowadays. As we said, the story features a girl whose mother died, and she finds her way back to music by performing with ghosts, and she's the only one that can see them. Netflix did a great job here with a different cast and the perfect storyline. We have a Puerto Rican protagonist in Julie. There's a gay ghost, and the way Netflix addresses this topic is quite amazing. Also, as we said, this is a really rare thing to see in a show. Number 2, the music. Do you guys know why the show reached the success it did? Because the stars behind Julie and the Phantoms are more than just actors singing songs on screen. They're actually a real band. And if you need proof to understand how great their musical skills are, here it is. Their song went to iTunes number 1 spot the moment it was released. All the songs are so deep and have a great message. Every one of them makes you believe that everything's possible. The music in Julie and the Phantoms combines rock songs with stadium anthems. And once again, since Julie has been unable to make music since her mother died, the storyline fits perfectly with the amazing music choice. She's writing songs again after joining the ghostly musicians of the band Sunset Curve, Luke, Reggie, and Alex. Number 1. Fans of High School Musical. We believe there's not a person who hasn't heard about High School Musical. Chances are you had watched Zac Efron singing his heart out in High School Musical 1 through 3 a couple of times in your life. Are huge, especially back in those high school days when you wished nothing but being a part of something like that. A hot basketball player who has the best voice and looks all together was everything we cared about back then. And maybe we adored Zach in High School Musical, but Julie and the Phantoms had not one, not two, but 3 new boys to break over. And they have the best time behind the scenes of the show. How amazing is that? Not to mention that Kenny Ortega, the person who directed the High School Musical movies, also directed Julie and the Phantoms. So guys, if you haven't watched Julie and the Phantoms, and if you're a big fan of High School Musical, what are you waiting for? Jump over to Netflix and enjoy your ride. We end our video here. What do you think about Julie and the Phantoms? Let us know in the comment section below. Make sure you like the video, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more amazing videos such as this. As always, thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for watching.